South Africa, a deadly confrontation at the world's third largest platinum mine. We need to warn you that this video is extremely graphic. You're going to see police opening fire on striking workers.
Groundswell of protest. Workers from diverse mines now joining forces. A national strike committee has been formed. The fledgling Democratic Socialist Movement plans a national strike on November the 3rd. It also plans a mass march to the union buildings.
It's Liv who is speaking from the Democratic Socialist Movement. We have been invited by your leaders to come and unite you. These big mine companies have made 40 billion profits per annum. With this profit, they can pay all workers.
Are these frustrated workers looking for an alternative or merely hoping for clear leadership?
We are not just looking for a party that would promote the narrow interests of, you know, a black middle class in this country, as we have seen with the ANC, but also, you know, the latest being COPE and other, you know, splinter groups that have emerged since, you know, 1994. We are looking for a party that first and foremost will unite the working class in struggle.
Political party conceived in the mines. Those driving the workers and Socialist Party have confidence in its success.
Other union movements which were in place in this country, they failed the majority of our employees during the strikes that has engulfed the country since last year. Until today. So that is why we came up with this idea of forming Workers and Socialist Party, which is going to be the fighting vanguard of workers.
The party says its main aim is to fight for the poor, improving lives by redistributing wealth. Many have welcomed the new movement.
What I like about this party is that they are working together with the community. You know, unlike those ones who are in offices, who are being elected to be in offices, but they are doing nothing on the ground level.
And therefore, comrades, when the mine workers went on strike last year, they were not going on strike only on their own behalf. Nor were they simply going on strike for higher wages or better conditions. It was a rebellion against the entire political and economic order that had been agreed at CODESA before the elections of 1994. Now, comrades, there are many workers who have said to us, is the Workers and Socialist Party just a party for mine workers? And we are saying no, it is a party for the entire working class. But it is not an accident that the birth of the resistance against capital, the uprising against the capitalist class as a whole, should have begun in the mining industry.